Sonia Lubomirsky did research on people and discovered that 50% of the world's population, almost exactly 50% of the world's population, is born with what scientists call the happiness gene. That means we're a glass half full person. I'm one. You know whether you're a glass half full person or a glass half empty person, or as glass half empty people like to call themselves, realists. People without the happiness gene, they're kind of, you know, not necessarily happy most of the time. Happiness comes a little harder to them. It takes a little bit more work, but the cool news is the tools that we're going to play with today actually work better for people who are glass half empty people. So that's the 50% number. Doesn't matter whether you were born in abject poverty or in Warren Buffett's back pocket right next to his American Express Centurion card. Doesn't matter your life circumstances. You're either glass half full, you got the happiness gene, or you're glass half empty, you didn't get it. But it's okay. Let's talk about the 10%. The 10% means the 10% of the time that our primitive brain takes over. Something really fabulous happens and we're just over the moon, excited and happy. Maybe you hit the real Powerball lottery. How long is that smile going to stay on your face? It's going to stay there for a while, isn't it? You're going to wake up in the morning and go, oh, for days. Now, conversely, sometimes the primitive brain kicks in when something bad happens. Might be that you just got a brand new car and somebody bashed into it. That iceberg in the pit of your stomach is going to be there for a while. So sometimes, about 10% of the time, slightly less, the primitive brain just takes over. And there's nothing we can do about it. The higher brain will eventually kick back in and take over, but that's the 10% number. The 40% is where we all have control. It's how we choose to think about things. Harvard research discovered that there's a mistake in the way that we think about happiness. Most of us are raised to think that if we set a goal and we work really hard to achieve that goal, then once we achieve the goal, we're going to be happier, right? Wrong. Doesn't work that way. Actually, you'll be happy for the red hot minute that you get your goal, and then you're going to drop right back down to your baseline level after that. So you have to keep getting a goal and keep getting a goal and keep getting a goal to keep hitting that happiness. It doesn't actually raise your natural level of happiness like these tools will do. You ready to play with some tools?